Hey everybody, my name is Lexx Davis and I'm from Capitol Heights, Maryland of the United States. I was a part of News Release Basketball of 2016. And one of the things that really stood out to me on my tour was just all the great people I encountered. From my News Release family to the kids of the camps, the parents of the kids, the hosts. Everybody was just really great and welcoming and loving, and I'm happy to have made so many bonds. During this Power Minute, I want to talk about renewing our spirit during hard times, because I know sometimes we can go through things that have us feeling really down and hopeless, and we feel like we don't know what to do, we feel like we don't have anything left to give. So I heard a sermon recently, and I want to share it with you all. I'll be reading a passage from the Bible, and this is the New Living Translation. I'll be reading from Ezekiel chapter 37, verses 1 through 14. And feel free to pause the video and read it on your own if you need to. This is titled, A Valley of Dry Bones. The Lord took hold of me and I was carried away by the Spirit of the Lord to a valley filled with bones. He led me all around among the bones that covered the valley floor. They were scattered everywhere across the ground and were completely dried out. Then he asked me, Son of man, can these bones become living people again? O sovereign Lord, I replied, you alone know the answer to that. Then he said to me, speak a prophetic message to these bones and say, dry bones, listen to the word of the Lord. This is what the sovereign Lord says. Look, I am going to put breath into you and make you live again. I will put flesh and muscles on you and cover you with skin. I will put breath into you and you will come to life. Then you will know that I am the Lord. So I spoke this message just as he told me. Suddenly, as I spoke, there was a rattling noise all across the valley. The bones of each body came together and attached themselves as complete skeletons. Then as I watched, muscles and flesh formed over the bones. Then skin formed to cover their bodies, but they still had no breath in them. Then he said to me, speak a prophetic message to the wind, son of man. Speak a prophetic message and say, this is what the sovereign Lord says. Come, O breath from the four winds, breathe into these dead bodies so they may live again. So I spoke the message as he commanded me, and breath came into their bodies. They all came to life and stood up on their feet, a great army. Then he said to me, son of man, these bones represent the people of Israel. They are saying we have become old, dry bones. All hope is gone. Our nation is finished. Therefore, prophesy to them and say, this is what the sovereign Lord says. O my people, I will open your graves of exile and cause you to rise again. Then I will bring you back to the land of Israel. When this happens, O my people, you will know that I am the Lord. I will put my spirit in you, and you will live again and return home to your own land. Then you will know that I, the Lord, have spoken, and I have done what I said. Yes, the Lord has spoken. So in this passage, it shows that God is able to restore things physically and spiritually. In the first half of the passage, it shows that these dry bones were scattered among the valley, and once God's word was spoken over them, they formed together and were covered with muscle and flesh. But in verse 8, it says that, but they still had no breath in them. So that means that they were not ready, they were not complete. And then God's word was spoken over them again, and he commanded the breath to enter these dead bodies so they may live again. And so once his word was spoken over them, they came to life and stood up on their feet and became a great army. So then in verse 11 and on, it says that these bones represent the people of Israel. They are saying we have become old, dry bones and all hope is gone. So they were hopeless. It says that our nation is finished. They had nothing left. And so once God's word was spoken over them, he said that he will put his spirit in them and they will live again and they will return home. So it seems to be the bottom line of this passage is God's word and God's spirit. In order for things to be restored, God's word had to be spoken over them, and God's spirit had to be spoken in them. So what I've learned is that when I go through my hard times, I can't be stuck in my hopelessness. I have to at least find the strength to pray to God and to seek his word and to speak his word over myself and my situation, and I have to allow His Spirit to fill me and to guide me in the right direction. So I hope that I've helped someone that's watching this video, and I hope that you can help someone else. And let us end in prayer. Lord, thank you for allowing us to be here today. Thank you for being with us in this very moment. Lord, I pray that you would forgive us for any wrong that we have done, and I pray that you will help us make it right. Lord, thank you for protecting us and guiding us even when we aren't even aware. Lord, I pray that you uplift any worries or burdens that we have that we cannot carry on our own. Lord, you are strong and you are always capable of anything. Even what seems impossible in our lives, Lord, you can handle. And I just thank you for always doing just that, handling it. Lord, I pray that you will touch someone that needs you right now, Lord, that needs your physical and spiritual restoration, Lord. I pray that you would guide them in their lives. Cover them in their situation with your word and fill them with your Holy Spirit, Lord. Thank you. In your name. And His grace is enough.